What is up, guys? It is Christ, and we are back with another video. Welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to the Megadeth Monday. I know I am doing an unpardonable sin right now by wearing a Metallica shirt on a Megadeth video, but ultimately, I don't have a Megadeth shirt right now, and this is the closest I've been. At least Dave was in Metallica at one point. I'll say that. So it's technically a technicality right there. But anyways, so with that being said, we're going to have a total of four videos today, four songs. One of them is actually a live version of one I've heard. You guys keep asking me for Symphony of Destruction. Unfortunately, I have heard that one, so that's the reason that song is not on the channel. It has not been on the channel. But we will be doing a live video simply for completionist sake. And this one, Holy Wars, Peace Sells, and Kill the King are my four big ones that I've heard before I actually started this channel, long before I started the channel. Anyways, let's get down with some Black Curtains. I think this is one of the last ones on Euthanasia, or it is the last one that I have to do. Pretty excited to hear it, but I'm also kind of sad that this album's coming to a close because I really enjoyed Euthanasia. It's probably the favorite that I have reacted to because of all the different elements to the album that I really like. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So this is supposedly the darkest and heaviest on the album. Okay, interesting riff. Ooh, okay. Okay, so far it's got a really sort of really cool and dark and foreboding sort of guitar riff in the beginning, which I really like. Ooh, that riff is sick. Sounds like nuclear war. There's some really cool riffs. I think that I wish there was some variation with the chorus riff. That's really the only sort of critique I have about it so far. Okay. Ooh. A spider's web. Ooh, really nice guitar solo. Now, the black curtains are metaphorical in this aspect, and I'm trying to figure out what they are really meaning. This is a really good guitar solo. I don't know who it is, though. Marty, I believe, is the other guitarist during this era. The verse riff is really cool. Definitely, the one I heard last week, Killing Road, was also pretty heavy. This one's definitely pretty heavy too, but I'm kind of torn which is heavier. That being said, this one's certainly got a lot of really cool, like, dark riffs in it. There you guys have it. That was Black Curtains. That was a pretty good song. I do have to say, I think I enjoyed Killing Road a little bit better. But this one was also a really good song. Of course, Killing Roads was kind of hard to beat because that was such a good song. But this one's definitely, I think they said this one was closer. And if it is a closer, it is definitely a worthy closer. But it's not quite as heavy, in my opinion, as Killing Road. Oh, apparently it's not. It could be. Yeah, Victory Absolution. No, Victory. I think I've heard Victory before. Yeah, I have. But overall, super solid song. Really enjoyed it. And it was definitely a good start to today's video. I don't know too much about what the black curtains in and of itself are. I know that he's talked about death and destruction and that kind of stuff. But as to what the actual black curtains are, I'm not sure. The song meaning and the song, the black curtains are a metaphor for something. I can't quite put my finger on it. Maybe this will. Okay. There's a lot of stuff that I cannot pronounce in that. I am not a scientist, nor am I going to pretend to be. But apparently it might have something to do with nuclear, destruction, like I suspected. Anyways, pretty good song. I'm going to rate it. I'm going to give us a 4.75 because there was a little bit of variation I would have liked to have seen on the chorus of riff. It was da 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 da, and they could have went up like da 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 or something like that. But it was just the same chord used over and over, which I thought was kind of repetitive. But other than that, like small section, I thought that the rest of the song had some really, really good riffs in it, super solid riffs. That's the only critique I have, is that it felt kind of repetitive in that one section. But other than that, pretty good song. Let's move on to the next one. So this is Symphony of Destruction. I don't really need to get the lyrics out for this one, but this is definitely one of my favorites. Definitely one of their softest ones, in my opinion, but super chuggy, super heavy. Well, it's heavy. It sounds heavy in the same sense that the thing that should not be by Metallica is heavy. It's really slow and I have a hard time describing this song. It's just on the slower side, definitely on the more simplistic side, but also pretty heavy at the same time. Definitely curious to see what this one sounds like. It's got 4 million views, so hopefully it's pretty good. I love that bass line. Dave's voice sounds pretty good. And put him in control. Watch him become a god. Watch people's heads are all. This song definitely has some of the best riffs that I've ever heard Megadeth do. But the verse can be kind of simplistic. But it works. Just like I'll talk about it afterwards. My thoughts on the song. Dave's voice definitely sounds pretty good in this song. They're playing super tight too. Definitely better than Lars. The harmonizing is actually pretty good too. I don't really know how trained the vocalists are, the backup vocalists, but they sound pretty good. I am solo. Now, I'm gonna feel really bad, but I don't think that's Marty. I've seen videos of Marty, and I think his hair is darker than that. Unless he just dyed it. So I don't know who this is. Overall, super solid performance of the song so far. This has always been one I wanted to learn. I haven't attempted it in a long time, though.
Peaceful man stands tall.
Oh yeah.
Just like fight fighters, let rats use this. You can sing Mary Lynn, swear to the symphony. Just like
super solid performance. That was actually pretty awesome. What makes me mad is they never do the actual full song. I would love it if Metallica would actually do the full song, but they always cut it short right at the fast section, and it makes me so mad when they do that. There's another song they do that with. I just can't think of the name of it right now. Overall, super solid performance. Here's my thoughts on Symphony of Destruction. Out of all the fan favorites, that's probably my least favorite. I find it rather simplistic, but that being said, it's still a very good song. I think that the verse riff is definitely on the more repetitive side, and I wish they would have done more with it. The same way that The Thing That Should Not Be by Metallica, I love that song, but the verse riff is pretty repetitive. It dun 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 dun. So it's like, it's pretty repetitive, and this is sort of the same way in that sort of sense. But other than that, it's got some really cool riffs throughout the rest of the song, like the chorus and the solo and the, I guess, interludes, the small sections like that. The guitar solo is very, very nice in the song. The drum work is definitely on the more simplistic side, but it works for the song. Everything works for the song. I just wish there was more variety, especially in the verse riff. It seems like they just kind of made up that one riff and sort of wrote it throughout the rest of the song. I know I'm probably going to get some dislikes for saying this, saying that Symphony isn't my favorite, but I got to be honest with you guys. I wouldn't be lying to you guys. So definitely think it's a good song, but it's definitely not one of the best, in my opinion. Anyways, with that being said, let's go ahead and go on to the next one. This one's going to be Problems. This is one that apparently I haven't done off of Hidden Treasures. And so pretty excited to check it out. And apparently this is actually one by, it's a cover. I think they were mentioning Sex Pistols. So this may be a cover of a different artist. Let's see. I'm pretty sure that they had said in the comments that this was a cover of a Sex Pistols song. But we're about to find out. So without further ado, let's go ahead and check it out. Hopefully this isn't like an unnecessary remaster. I didn't check, but oh well. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay. Okay, yeah, it is covered by the Sex Pistols. Ooh. Ooh, Dave's vocals are pretty good on this song. Definitely have a really different sound to it. Definitely got some attitude in this one. Ooh, I can hear the bass pretty good in this one. Drums are very good too. I haven't quite figured out what this song's about, but it's pretty good. I really like the riffs so far. They're really good in this song. Super solid. Okay. All right. All right. I think this cover is way better than the Anarchy in the UK. I wasn't really a fan of Anarchy in the UK in the first place, the Sex Pistols one, so. But this one is definitely way better. Is kind of repetitive in this though. Okay, he's jumping back and forth. Okay, this is kind of, I think the instrumentation is nice, but the chorus is very, very repetitive. All right, there you guys have it. That was Megadeth's Problems cover of the Sex Pistols. I definitely thought it was better than Anarchy in the UK. Now, here's the thing. I don't like Anarchy in the UK. The Sex Pistols, or really the Megadeth one. I thought the Megadeth one was better, but I just, the song itself is just so, bland to me that I just don't really care for it. This one, on the other hand, there was a lot of aggression, there was a lot of attitude, there was a lot of really cool riffs in here, and I definitely liked this song. The song was actually pretty good, but I would say that the, sorry, just woke up. The chorus is definitely on the repetitive side, and it definitely got kind of annoying at the end there, how many times he said problem. But other than that, I thought it was a pretty good song. I'm going to give this one a 4 because that chorus is definitely really repetitive. It was okay the first couple times, but then after that, it got really repetitive. So that's the reason it gets knocked down a little bit. So anyways, with that being said, let's go ahead and check out Psychotron. Now, I don't know if I've done this song before. There's been a couple of videos where I did a surprise song, and I deliberately did not put it down in the tags so that it would be a surprise to anybody that watched the video. So I don't think I did this song, but I apologize if I do, and if I did, I'm going to go ahead and end it here. So yeah. Let's go ahead and check out Psychotron, but like I said, if I have, thank you guys for watching. Okay, it definitely seems like it's going to be a more mid-tempo. So far, pretty heavy in terms of the intro. Ooh, okay. All right. Hello. Finally, we got a song over 4 minutes long. They got a few. Apparently, this is about Deathlock. Ooh. Hello. Got some nice lead. His vocal style definitely is very reminiscent of P-Cells. And this song definitely reminds me of P-Cells. Just the lead play, the way he's doing that little snarky voice, it definitely reminds me of P-Cells. This is definitely a pretty good song. I would say this might actually be the best one today. This is nice. Okay, this is nice. I like this one. Ooh. Now, I don't know if Deathlock is a villain or not. It's not. I don't want to know that. Okay, so he's apparently anti-villain, or rather anti-hero turned protagonist. Super good song so far. Alright, we're going to a solo. Got some lead, nice lead play. This song definitely has some really nice little short little lead play sections. I really enjoy it. Of course, the Marvel Cinematic Universe is different from the comics. He may be an actual villain in the comics. This song is definitely, I would say, the best one I've heard today. That chorus riff is just so catchy. Oh, okay, yes, yes. Why didn't you guys recommend this one sooner? You guys know how much I like Marvel. Okay, I figure. Okay. I thought that song was amazing. I think the intro could have been a little bit better. It would have been awesome if they would have went for a big big climax to the song where they were doing double bass, possibly continuing the chorus, I guess, riffs, and it just repeating Psychotron over and over until the song ended. I thought I was expecting that, and I didn't hear it. So just sort of like every one of the instruments dropped off. And Dave just echoed Psychotron a few times. I thought that song was absolutely amazing. Okay, I haven't quite made a top 10 list yet. Because every time I think I've got a list, another song comes along and pushes another one out. So I'm definitely going to make a top 10 Megadeth songs definitely in the near future. But this song, I hesitate to call it top 10, but it was really good, and it definitely reminded me in the best of ways of Peace Sells. I thought that the riffs in this song were absolutely amazing. Dave's snarky voice definitely reminded me a lot of Peace Sells, as well as they would do like a little bit of lead play in between each of the verse lines. Well, some of the verse lines, not every single one. But that is definitely very reminiscent of Peace Sells, and so I really, really enjoyed this song. I think the ending could have been a little bit better, but I'm not going to knock it for that. This song was definitely a 5 for me. I really, really enjoyed this song. Yeah, that's going to be it for today's video. Overall, I think that the songs were definitely at the very least great, but this was truly the only awesome song on here, in my opinion. Symphony, I've heard before. Black Curtains was good, and so was the... What's that other one? I feel bad now because I don't remember what it was. The name of the song, getting a brain fart right now. Problems. Problems was definitely repetitive. It had its flaws. Symphony, I've heard before, and I definitely don't think it's as great as a lot of the other hits. And Black Curtains was I would say Black Curtains is second. I would say I would put Symphony third, and then Problems last. Problems definitely took the biggest hit because of the amount of repetitiveness. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I just want to give a quick thank you. Last week, for some reason, we ended up getting almost 500 views for a Megadeth video, and that has not happened in a very, very long time. So thank you guys so much for supporting that and checking that out. It is definitely appreciated. Hopefully this gets the same amount of views, and hopefully we start to pick up some traction on Megadeth. Megadeth actually beat out every other band last week, which is pretty insane. Like, I did not expect that to happen. Normally, Megadeth is sort of middle of the pack, but last week, Megadeth ended up beating everything, which was pretty awesome. So thank you guys so much for that. Anyways, we'll see you guys later.